Yes, good. Me too, fine. Thank you. Okay, class. Today, I would like to welcome in this virtual class of class 10 in this compulsory English. And in the previous class, we have discussed about the poem, The Road Not Taken, which is written by or composed by the famous American poet Robert Lee Frost. And we have got concept about the poem, and we recite the poem, and we summarize the poem, and we got an idea about the center idea or the theme of the poem. And now in today's class, we are going to discuss about the exercises related to the poem The Road Not Taken. And the exercise is, you will see in the page number 94, page number 94 under text, you see there 94, and it is vocabulary in use. You look at in your textbook at the page number 95, question number 1, exercise number 1 is vocabulary in use. We will here classify the vocabulary given in the given below according to the relation with the first road and the second road. Some words or some vocabulary are related to the first road and some are related to the second road. We will classify them according to the poem we discussed yesterday. Okay, did you get me? Yes. Now, it is the concept about the poem. Now here, you can see here in a textbook here is vocabulary in use. You see in question number 1, exercise number 1, vocabulary in use. You can get some idea from here. I would like to show you a chart here. Okay, now see here. You can see on your textbook, question number 1, exercise number 1, vocabulary practice. Vocabulary in use here, you see here, following words are described either of the two roads the poet is talking about in the poem. Fill the table below choosing appropriate words or word given below. Here, you can see some of the words which are taken from the poem the poet has given here, and these some are related to the first road and some words are related to the second road here. And let me show you the poem here. In the poem you will see here those words. Now see here, bent in the undergrowth, fair, better, grassy, worn, trodden back, less travel. These are the words which are taken here from the poem. Now the first word is here, bent in the undergrowth. It is the phrase here. Now you see here, this phrase is related to the first road or the second road. You can see here in the poem. See here in the first stanza. Two roads diverge in a yellow wood. And sorry I could not travel both and be one traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Here, see here, bent in the undergrowth. This is the phrase related to which road? Yes, the first road. You see here, two roads diverge in the yellow wood. Sorry, I couldn't travel good. The poet is saying he is sorry. But here, what he tries to do? He tries to look down one as far as I could. Means he looked one of the road, the first road, as far as he could. And the first road was bent in the undergrowth. This is the phrase related to the first road. You see here now, bent in the undergrowth. Okay. Bent in the undergrowth is related to the first road. Now you see here fair. Where is the fair now? Now see here fair. The word next word is fair. Then took the other is just as fair, and having perhaps better claim because it was grassy and wanted way, though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. You see here, one as far as I could means this one before the first road, and this, the second one, you then took the other. Now this other refers to the second road, so that this other then took the other is just as fair. This fair is the word which is related to the second word. So that, now write this fair, the word is related to the second word. Now you see that. Okay. Now the next one is, the next word is better. You see. And having perhaps the better claim, he feels the second road is better. He demands that. That is the better one. So that the word better also is related to the second word. Okay, see. And the next one is grassy. Also, in the second stanza we can see, because it was grassy and wanted way. This grassy is the word that is also related to the second word here. So now let me write here grassy on the second word. And now let's see the next one. Next word is the worn. Worn, you see here the worn. Because it was grassy and wanted with. Though as far that the passing deer had warned them really about the same year. Had warned, you see here. Though as far that the passing deer had warned here, the had is related to the first stanza, so that this one is the word which is related to the first word. You can see here, so that please let me write this one. The one is the word related to the first word. One. And now let me show you the next stanza part. Prodom black here is here. Now see here. And both that morning equally lay. In leaves no step had prodom black. It means, and both that morning equally lay. In leaves no step had prodom black. Oh, I keep the first for another day. Yet, knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. Here the poet mentioned the Trodden Black for the both road is here. Now see here. And both that morning quietly. This both refers here the two roads here, so that we can write this the Trodden Black on the two roads, both roads, the first road and the second road. Trodden Black. you see here. And now the last word is less travel. Now you see here, less travel. You see here, I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere, ages and ages hence, two road diverged in a wood, and I took the one less travel. I took the one less travel by, and that has made all the difference. That less travel with the poet or the traveler choose the second road, as I mentioned in the poem, so that less travel road is related to the second road. Less travel. Okay. Now, dear student, solve the exercise that is related to the vocabulary in use number 2. You see here number 2. In the page number 95, you see here, match the following words. Match the following words with their meaning. Some words which are taken from the poem, and in one column there are given some words, and in next column there are given the meaning of those words. And now I'd like to solve this exercise on whiteboard using some of the flashcard. Now see, the first word is diverged. You see here, diverse. And now you can see there other words. What is the meaning of the diverse there? A deep and long breath, walked on, branched away, demand, forest, soft a mass of bushes, from now on, curved. Among these four words, which one is the meaning of diverse? You see in your textbook and tell me please. What is the meaning of diverse? Thank you. The meaning of diverse is branched away. Okay. Branched away. You see here now. Branched away. The meaning of the word diverse is branched away. Now let me see the next word. Wood. What is the meaning of wood? You see here the word wood. What is the meaning of the wood? You see here a deep and long breath, walked on, demand, forest, soft a mass of bushes, from now and on, and curved. Let me tell please. Yes. The forest. The meaning of wood is forest. Now, I would like to paste it on the board here. Now, forest. Let me see the next word, undergrowth. What is the meaning of the word undergrowth used in poem? Here, undergrowth. The word you can choose from there. Are you ready, please? Yes, see here. A deep and long breath, walked on, demand, soft a mass of bushes, from now on, curved. Which one is? Yes, please. The meaning of undergrowth is soft a mass of bushes. Let me show you here. A mass of, okay, soft or a mass of bushes. As I mentioned you on a previous picture on a slide, I have shown you that undergrowth is soft a mass of bushes. I have also shown in the picture also. Okay, now let me see the next word, clan. What is the meaning of the word clan here? Please, I would like to paste it on whiteboard. Clan. What is the meaning of clan? Which one? A deep and long breath, worked on demand from now on curve. What is the claim? Can you tell me?
Yes.
The meaning of claim is demand. Okay, you see here, demand. Okay, let me see the next word now, please. Sir, S-I-G-S, sir. What is the meaning of the word sir? The word sir, here. Now see there, a deep and long breath worked on, from now on, and curve. Among these meaning, which one is the appropriate meaning of the word sigh? Disturb me? Yes. The word. The meaning of the word sigh is, let me, as you said here, you see here, a deep and long breath. As I mentioned you earlier, sigh means having a long breath. A deep and long breath. It may be with the surprise, with the happiness, or it may with the sadness or unsuccess in life. It may come. It is related to our emotion. Okay, now the next word, let me tell you, turtle. What is the meaning of the word turtle? You see here, turtle. What is the meaning of the word turtle? Can you tell me how many words are left here? Work on, from now on, and curve. One of those three words are left now. Which one among these? Yes. As you said, as you replied to me, work on. Work done is the meaning of the word trodden. Okay, let me tell you the next word, bent. B-E-N-T, bent. See here. Bent. What is the meaning of the word bent? Okay, let me. Meaning of the words are left here. Now, let me. Worked on, branch away, forest, soft of mass of bushes, demand a deep and long breath. Now, it has already gone now. We have left only the other two words. Now, let me tell me the meaning of the words bend. Yes. Right. Good. Okay. Bend means curve. Thank you. And now, we have left the one last word. That is called hands. Okay, what is the meaning of the word hands? Yes, the meaning of word hands is from now on, as a result. As a result, from now on. Okay, now let me show with arrow. Divorce means branched away. Old means forest. Undergrowth means soft or masses of bush. Claim means demand. Sigh means deep and long breath. Total means worked on. Bent means curved, not straight. And the last word, hence, means from on now. From on now. From now on means as a result. As now. We have discussed today about the poem, The Road Not Taken, and we have done also some exercises too. And we are in the conclusion now. I hope you got my point. I hope you can now summarize the poem. You got now the main theme of the poem. And dear student, you will practice at your home. You will practice at your home this exercise. Now, I hope that you are clear about the poem, and here are some of the questions related to the poem. You will see here the questions for practice now. You see, the first question, who is this figure in the poem? Yes. Robert Lee First is this figure in the poem. Yes. Next question, where is this figure standing in this poem? Where is this figure standing in this poem? Speaker means traveler here. Yes. The speaker is standing in this poem where? Yes. On a yellow road, on a dive, in front of the diverse road. Okay, now let me next one. Why does he stop here for a long time? Why? Why the speaker stopped here for a long time? Yes, he stopped here for a long time because he is in Delhi. He is in Delhi, man. To choose which road? It means he is standing in front of the diverse road. He stood there for a long time. Why he took a long time? Why he stops there? Because he got confusion to choose the which road. So that he stops there for a long time. Yes. Now see the next question. Why is he in a dilemma means? Why? Why is he in confusion there? Okay, he is in confusion about to choose the which road. It means there are the two roads and he seems in dilemma that to choose the best among the to choose the better road among two. Now let's see which road does he choose to travel? Which road? Yes, he chooses the second road to travel. Now, next question. Why does he leave the other one? Why does he leave the other one? Yes, he leaves the other one to walk. To walk second time. If he thought he will come next day and he will walk that left road second time. Or we can write another answer of this question also. He leaves the other one because he choose the road less traveled by the people. Next question. Is the speaker optimistic? How can you say this? Yes, the speaker seems optimistic. He says, I will walk that another walk next day or next time. It shows his optimistic means he has a hope of doing the next walk also. It means he left the first road, he chooses the second road. Even if he thinks that I will walk next to that road, it shows the speaker seem optimistic. It means we have to optimistic in our life as a speaker seems in the poem. And how can you say this means, as I already mentioned you that the poet has a hope to walk the next road again. Do you think he has made the right decision? Yes. Do you think? Yes. I think he has made the right decision. Why? Because his decision made difference of his life means he has the successful life at last. So that in my view he has made the right decision. Now the next question, what do you think the road referred to? Yes, the road referred to the life of human. It means the goals of human life or the goals of our life here. And next question, what is the central idea of the poem? What is the central idea of the poem? What thing you got in the poem? Can you tell me? Yes. The central idea of the poem, as you mentioned, that we should be optimistic in life. And next one is, we should choose the good alternatives in life. There are many more alternatives, and while choosing one alternative among more, we should choose the best one which impact best in our future. Okay, please, you will write this answer of this question at your home, or you will practice, please. I have mentioned for you in your practice. Okay, thank you for watching me.